When I grow up, I'm going to be a nurse.
I want to be an artist. I want to be a football player.
When I grow up, I want to be a teacher. I want to be a baseball player.
I want to be the world's best piano player. I want to be a secretary.
When I grow up, I want to be a policeman.
Hey, Danny, are you ready?
Hi, my name's Dan. That's my friend George. Today he's going to show me what it's really like to be a policeman.
We return now to When I Grow Up.
This is the police academy, and the people who are studying to become policemen are called trainees. After the 16-week course you take here, you join the force of the rookie. You spend a year as a rookie, and then, if you've made the grade, you become a full-fledged policeman.
Think about it, and we play our game with promises.
At least it's just like the school I go to.
Well, it is an ordinary school, so it can teach you the special things you need to know about being a policeman.
Reaction to stress. What does it do? It does three things. You have a negative effect, and you're not only dealing with that individual person, you're dealing with the spectators. Convey that I'm not strong, I'm not dependable, I cannot handle the situation. Out of stress comes anger, comes anxiety, and fear. Is that really the victim or?
Where are we going now, George?
To the class where they teach the trainees how to care for their weapons.
And they discover that there's no weapon there. I've forgotten my gun. Now, you may think that that's hard to believe, but it is a fact.
Isn't learning how to care for your weapon about as important as knowing how to use it?
Yes, it is, Danny, because if you don't know how to care for it, you might not be able to use it when you need it.
When you get finished, you're going to get up, you have it at this time, keep it up and out of the way. Take the ammunition that you have in the weapon and put that in your pocket. And then
I didn't know it at the time. But on the second floor of the academy, right above where George and I are standing, is a whole gymnasium.
This is a self-defense class, Danny.
That's where they teach all that kung fu stuff and stuff like that?
No, nothing that fancy. They just teach you how to fall without hurting yourself, how to break different holds.
How do you break a hold?
Well, it's pretty easy. Would you like to try it?
Sure.
Tony, can I interrupt you a minute?
Yes, sir.
Would you like to show Danny how to break a chokehold?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, sir.
Tony's not only a police officer, but an instructor, too. He teaches the trainees how to protect themselves in case they get into trouble. George says that the things you learn in Tony's class may not be very fancy, but they sure are good things to know.
Come on, Danny, before you hurt somebody. That's what you do.
Paul, we have a buzz, please.
Since we're only going to the chemistry lab, what do they need a buzz and door for to let us in?
Well, Danny, we have a lot of seized weapons and narcotics that are kept in the laboratory here, pending the cases as they're called to court.
Wow, there sure is a lot of equipment in here.
Let me introduce you to Joe over here, Danny. He can tell you the different uses. Hi, Joe. This is Danny. Danny. Joe.
Danny, how are you doing?
I never thought there'd be a place like this in the police station.
Well, Danny, let me show you some of the type of police work we do around here.
When a piece of evidence is turned into the chemistry lab, all kinds of tests are run on it. They have chemicals and equipment that can break down, to the smallest particle, the ingredients of a pill that's no bigger than the head of a pin. Their scientific findings, along with the other facts of the case, are then put into a final legal report.
Now I'm going to make an honest man out of you, Danny.
You mean you're going to give me a lie detector test?
That's right. Only we don't call it a lie detector anymore. We call it a polygraph.
Wow, this looks like it's going to be fun.
Hi, Lieutenant. This is Danny. This is Lieutenant William Armstrong.
How are you?
Danny, George tells me you're going to be a policeman. I'm happy to hear that because I think that there's a lot of need for good, honest police officers. Danny, have you ever had a polygraph test?
No, sir.
I'm glad to hear that because we make it a habit, a strong rule, never giving young children polygraph tests. You have to be over 14 years of age to take this test. But I think in this case, maybe we'd like to show you just how it runs. Would you like that?
Sure.
Good. Take off your jacket and have a seat right here where I'm standing. So I'm going to put this instrumentation on you, and as I do it, I just tell you what it is. These tubes, for instance, are known as pneumograph tubes. And what they're going to do, what they're going to do is measure your respiration or your breathing rate. And we're going to put one down low on your stomach there, and the other we're going to put high on your chest. The idea is by putting these on, we're going to be able to record any changes in breathing that occur during this test. Now, what does this look like to you?
Blood pressure testicle.
That's exactly what it is. It's a common doctor's blood pressure cup, the kind that your doctor uses to measure your heartbeat, pulse. And you just sit just like that, relax, and listen just like that.
Nice feet sweat, the same won't shock me.
No, you'll be safe. You've never lost anybody yet.
Okay.
Yeah, no problem. Just turn your hand over. Now, these, by the way, I told you we never lose anybody. And you just asked about being shocked. These are electrodes. These are finger electrodes. And they're going to measure the amount of skin sensitivity that you have. In other words, we're measuring the amount of skin secretions given off by their resistance to a very tiny electrical current you're going to introduce into your body. But it's 1/5,000th of a volt. So you won't be able to feel it and won't know what's going on. Alright, but now you do have to sit quietly. And during the test, we always ask the subject, that's you now, to look straight ahead. Is your first name Danny?
No.
Are you wearing an orange sweater today?
Yes.
Do you like ice cream?
Yes.
Okay, Danny, tell you one thing. You were telling the truth about the ice cream. I will have to report that to your father. I will take this instrumentation off and get out of here. Successfully undergone this polygraph test, which wasn't really bad, was it?
Well, I didn't get electrocuted.
At all, I didn't expect you would. This tape comes off fairly easy. I've undergone a test that thousands of people go through every day. It's true that they are telling the truth. Without any problem. A little souvenir. We're going to give you this chart.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Well, Danny, how did it feel?
Not bad, but it's better if you tell the truth.
Oh,
Hi, Jerry.
How are you?
George, how are you doing?
Hi, thanks. Who's your friend here?
This is my friend Danny. Danny, this is Sergeant Jay Canada.
He's commanding
the dispatching section here. Do you think you could show Danny how the dispatching system works?
Certainly.
You know, what? How does it work? Are all these people just doing practically the same thing?
Well, practically the same thing, yes. When the public calls here, they call here to get the car sent to their home or wherever the problem might be.
And what are those green and red lights mean up on the console?
That's the status board. That tells the dispatchers what cars are in and out of service. The green light indicates that the car is available for a call. The red light indicates that the car already has a call. And if there's no light on at all, that means the car is not on the street side at a particular time period.
What are those funny-looking things that look like hands writing on those papers?
Yeah, they are kind of funny-looking, aren't they? That is because that what you see being written on that paper there is being written at the same time in the back room by a person. And this machine copies it and sends it out to the dispatcher.
Bad guys don't have a chance with you guys around.
That's the idea, Dan. No matter how hard we try or how good we get, there's always going to be somebody that breaks the law.
Well, what do you do to them when they break the law?
Well, let's go find out. Jay, thanks for your time. Glad to see you again.
Nice to meet you, Dan.
Thanks a
lot.
This is the ID section, Dan. After the prisoners are booked, they're brought here for fingerprinting and photographing. Come on, we'll run you through. You can keep it as a souvenir and show the kids at school. Would you like to meet some members of the force who work in special assignments?
What do you mean? I thought all patrolmen did practically the same thing.
Well, we all uphold the law, but some of us work in special assignments.
Oh, I see.
I thought maybe we'd go to the stables and see how the mounted policemen work.
All right.
Danny and George will be back after this message. We continue now with When I Grow Up.
Hi, George. Nice to see you.
How are you?
Hi, Dan. How are you?
Pretty good.
I understand you want to be a policeman when you grow up.
Yes, sir.
Mike, I thought Danny would like to see how it feels to be part of the modern patrol. You think we could give it a try?
Oh, sure. Yeah. Come on. Let me give you a leg up here, Danny.
Mm-hmm.
horse I'm riding's name is Poco, which in Spanish means little one, and the one George is riding is named Chief. Both Poco and Chief are quarter horse geldings, and in addition to all the hay they can eat, they also get 2 quarts of feed a day. The officer is assigned to the mounted patrol. He and his horse go through a 7-week training period so that they can get used to each other and can get used to working together.
Well, how'd it go, guys? You ready to join up?
Yep.
Very good, Mike. Listen, we're going to have to go, so thanks for your time.
Yeah, sure.
What other special policemen are there, George?
Well, I thought maybe we'd go to the kennels where the canine corps is kept. We'll see how they operate.
Well, you wouldn't get me out in the middle of that street with all that traffic.
Well, Danny, he's another special type of policeman. Without him, we'd have all kinds of traffic jams, and the people would have a hard time walking across the street.
Hi, this is Dan.
Hi,
Dan,
how are you?
Very glad to meet you.
Dan, it's Ralph. Danny,
how are you? Pretty good.
Danny's learning the different types of policemen that there are.
Is it okay if I pet him?
Sure can, Danny.
Well, I thought police dogs were supposed to be mean and he's pretty gentle.
Danny, they're only mean when they have to be.
Well, what kind of work do police dogs do?
Well, Danny, we use the dogs for finding burglars in buildings. We use them for narcotics, sniff lot of narcotics. We use them to find bombs. We use them to track people, such as walk-away from nursing homes, lost children, and also criminals.
Is there, like, a daily workout you give them to keep them in shape?
Well, we're always working with them to keep them sharp.
Danny, Luke recently got a citation for bravery. Why don't you tell him about it?
Well, Dan, Luke received the Medal of Heroism from the German Shepherd Dog Club. And that's for an incident where Luke was shot twice trying to free a hostage. And he's recovered from his wounds now, and he's back to work.
Well, I guess Luke really is a hero, then, huh?
I guess so, Dan.
Well, Dan, we better let Howard and Ralph get back to work. We'll see you later.
Okay, bye, Luke.
I'm a little hungry, Danny. How about you?
Yeah, I'm hungry too.
What do you say we go get a donut?
Hey, that sounds great to me.
Hi, Jerry.
Hi.
You have a cup of coffee, a nice milk, and 2 donuts, please.
I thought you'd be pretty excited. How long have you been on the force, George?
I've been a policeman a little over 12 years, Danny.
How do you like being a policeman?
I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Wow.
hurt?
No. You breathe okay?
Yeah.
You lift your arms
up? Yeah.
Well, what happened? Apparently, she was driving the street and lost control of the car and ran through a light bulb here. How do you feel?
Okay.
Are you injured?
No. No.
You sure?
Yeah.
We'll take you to the hospital.
No.
Tonight.
No. No.
She seems to be all right now. Okay, I'll see you back in the station.
Okay, fine.
Let's relax a little bit here.
She's all right, Dan. A little shaken.
Glad nobody was hurt.
So are we. So are we.
Well, there's a little bit more to being a policeman than I thought. But I still want to be a policeman when I grow up.
When I Grow Up continues following this message.
What I like to do, like making noise and making faces and making friends like you. And when we grow up, do you think we'll see that I'm still like you and you're still like me? I might be pretty, you might grow tall, but we don't have to change at all. I want to change because I still want to be with you.